Hi everybody, my name is Khalid Al-Zibdi. I am from Sultan Qaboos University, Oman. So the title of my talk for today is Date Palm Agro Waste as a Particulate Filler for Virgin and Recycled Post-Consumer Polypropylene. So first, I will introduce the topic and talk about our developed composites from the date palm residues and recycled and virgin polypropylene. Then we'll describe the methodology, which include the fiber treatment and the biocomposite production, and then characterization, followed by results and discussions, and then I will conclude. Wood plastic composite manufacturing consumes a high amount of wood. This will result in a serious threat to the forestry all over the world. So using agricultural residues instead actually is a good opportunity to fill in this wood shortage. In this project, we'll use the date palm agro residues to make biocomposites. Date palm are available, date palm trees are available in Middle East and in particular in the Gulf region in high amount. As we can see here in this graph, so the date palm is, as mentioned, in this region, the waste produced from date palm are in big amounts compared to other type of fibers from different trees. And different parts of the palm tree, the waste of those parts can be used as fibers, including like rachis, midrib, here and the pedicel. In this project, we use the waste from this part, the pedicel. For the fiber treatment, so we take the waste of that date palm pedicel, and then we trim it to smaller pieces, and then we put it in water for a certain time to be able to extract the fibers in untreated form. And then we use a developed method using accelerated heating, using microwave to treat the fiber. And then we grind it in a powder form to be mixed with the PB billets. So here we use the pulverizer to mix the PB and the powder form of fiber. DBB stands for date palm powder. So in for two forms of BB, virgin and recycled. So we use a twin screw extruder to mix the two ingredients in a melt state. And then we compress it in a compression machine to make panels to be tested. So here we use four types of biocomposites, like BB, virgin and recycled BB, untreated fiber in a powder form and treated. So we developed those four types of composites to see the difference, the effect of the first, the recycled BB compared to the virgin BB, and also the effect of the treatment on the properties, including physical properties, water absorption here we'll discuss, and mechanical properties to tensile and flexural properties. And then we'll present some results from for thermal degradation for the all of those specimens, followed by ECM images. So for the water absorption, as we can see here, this graph, so plotted as the filler content as function of the water absorption. So we can see for the recycled BB based biocomposite has less water absorption. When we do treatment, the water absorption will be cut more. So it will increase, of course, when we increase the fiber content, because the filler will absorb more water. For the tensile properties, for the tensile strength, Here we can see the recycled BB based biocomposites has less tensile strength. That makes sense, I mean. But when we make the treatment, both will increase and they are comparable here. And they will increase as we increase the fiber, the filler content due to certain issues, including the distribution of the filler in the matrix and also the interface, the compatibility between the fiber and the surrounding matrix. So for the Young's modulus, so we can see here we see that there is an increasing trend for the Young modulus as we increase the filler content. And also here we can see that for recycled and virgin BB based because they are comparable, the results. When we looked at the elongation at the break, so we can see that as we increase the filler content, the material becomes more brittle. So for the flexural properties, the improvement due to the treatment was more pronounced, but similar trend also if, compared to the tensile strength was observed here. Okay, but more improvement as I mentioned. So for the thermal analysis, so we can see here for the virgin BB based biocomposite, this is for untreated and this is for treated. When we do the treatment, so the peak was shifted to the right, which means that it will bear at higher, slight higher temperature, which means more stable. And this peak presents the evaporation of water and burning of other impurities. So for the recycled, actually we see a reverse trend. So there was no improvement in the thermal stability because the shift was to the left. So to support this by SM images for the tensile strength, for the untreated cases, we can see here, there is some weak interfaces between the DBB, the data bound powder and the matrix. This picture just a magnification of this one. So both for both virgin BB and recycled BB. So we can see here some issues for the interface. After the treatment, we can observe that there is some interlocking between the matrix and the fiber, that's which contributed to the increase in the tensile strength, actually for both cases, for the BB treated and for the recycled BB treated, so as was presented in the tensile strength. So to conclude that we developed two types of composites from date palm agro residues using virgin and recycled BB. So the recycled BB biocomposite showed less water absorption compared to the virgin BB bio-based composites. Fiber treatment was able to cut water absorption by 65% compared to the untreated ones. Although the recycled BB bio-based composite showed lower tensile strength compared to the virgin BB bio-based biocomposite, fiber treatment has reversed this trend, as we saw. Fiber treatment was more effective in improving the flexural strength of virgin BB bio-based composite compared to the recycled BB bio-based composites. And thermal stability was improved slightly in the case of the virgin BB bio-based composite, but was also reduced in the case of the recycled BB bio-based composites. That's my presentation, and thank you for your listening.